Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up a booking system on your WordPress website in under 5 minutes, and it's going to be completely free. So here's my demo site here, and I actually have a page for a contact form, but instead of a plain form, I want to have a booking calendar where users can come in here and book a time to talk with me. And so let's go ahead and get started, starting off by heading back to my WordPress dashboard. I'm going to head over to my plugins page, and I'm going to select the Add New button. Here on the plugins search bar, I'm going to type in simply, and that should be enough to bring up the booking plugin I'm going to be using in this, which is called Simply Schedule Appointments. So you can tell which one it is by the little fox icon. So I'm going to go ahead and install this and activate it. All right, so now that I have Simply Schedule Appointments installed, it's going to automatically add a new appointments tab to the left-hand WordPress sidebar. Opening up the appointments tab, you're going to be immediately greeted by the Foxy Setup Wizard. This is a little mascot, and it's asking you if you would like any help, and we'll go ahead and click yes. All right, so first thing it's going to do, it's going to automatically detect a few of my general settings, including the time zone, the format that I prefer for the date and time, as well as some contact information. So if it needs any adjusting, you can select the Need Some Adjusting button, but if it looks good, go ahead and click on Let's Go. All right, so now it's going to ask me to set up my first appointment type, and an appointment type is basically just a booking calendar and all the settings that go along with that. So here it is going to ask me what name I want for this booking calendar, along with the duration, minutes. The label feature is for organizational purposes. It's going to ask what booking view I want, and it's going to ask me if I want to show the user any instructions. I'm going to leave everything as is. I'm going to click continue. Next, we have our availability tab. This is going to help you set up the time slots. So you can choose whether you want available blocks, or you can choose specific start times if you're picky about when your appointments begin. And I'm gonna go with available blocks. And you can also choose the intervals for your time slots. You can go as high as 60 minutes or as small as 10 minute intervals. In this case, I'm just gonna go with 60, and I'm just gonna go ahead and fill out this entire block. This has a drag and draw editor, so you can use a little pencil to select the times that you're available and erase the ones that you're not. I'm going to go ahead and click continue. Next, we're going to go over some scheduling options. This includes the time zone, whether you want to localize this and auto detect the user's time zone or lock it to your time zone. In this case, let's go with localized. We can choose the appointment buffers, which is basically just how much padding you would like between these appointments. You can also choose the notice required, which helps you prevent last minute bookings. And we also have the per day limit, which lets you select how many you would like to receive in a day. We're gonna go ahead and click continue. And last, we have the customer information. This provides a set number of fields that you'd like to collect from your customers. If you would like to add more custom fields, you'll need to update to one of their premium editions. But for now, we're just going to stick with this free one because it does come with a lot of good fields that we typically want to ask for, including the phone number, address, city, state, zip code, and any additional notes. So I'm going to select the phone as required and the notes just to simply display. I'm going to click continue. And last, you'll have a quick panel to review everything that you just set up, just to confirm that this looks good. On the far right side, you'll notice that it does give you a few shortcodes that you can use to copy and paste into any place on your site, but we're going to be using the block editor to set up our booking calendar, so we can ignore this for now. I'm going to click continue, and that ends the setup wizard. It's going to congratulate you. Just to show you what the SSA dashboard looks like, I'm going to take you to the settings page. As you can see here, the free edition of this plugin comes with a few different tabs, including the appointments tab, where you can see all your new bookings, the appointment types, where you can create more calendars. Keep in mind that you can create an unlimited number of calendars even with the free edition. Next, we have our settings page, where you can update those general settings that we set up in the wizard. You can adjust the styles from here, add in translations, set up a few advanced scheduling options. You can also set up unlimited number of notifications, but the plugin already comes with 4. And lastly, you can enable blackout dates, and you can enable the calendar event settings. The blackout dates lets you block off all the time slots on specific days in case you go on vacation. And the calendar events lets you customize the add to calendar event event that comes up to users on the confirmation screen, and I can show you where that button's located here when we test a booking. Anyway, let's go back to our website and show you how to easily embed our brand new calendar. So heading back to my Let's Talk page, I'm going to go ahead and edit this page, and scrolling down to the Book a Consultation section, I'm actually going to open the navigator for this to help me easily maneuver around here. And I want to go ahead and add the booking calendar to this section right here. So all I have to do is click this plus button on the WordPress block editor in the top left corner, type up the word appointment, and that should bring up my appointment booking form module that comes with this plugin. So this actually comes with both the booking form module and the upcoming appointments module. But just keep in mind, the upcoming appointments is only for logged in users. All right, so dragging this into place, and right away you can see my booking calendar is displaying. If you look on the right hand side here on my block settings for this appointment booking form widget, you'll see that I can adjust a few different things. For example, if I want to show my appointment types by the label or simply just by their name, I can select that here. I can also, if I had more appointment types, I can select the all option, or I can just select a single one or multiple appointment types to display. I can also adjust the colors from here, which I'll go ahead and do because I do want it to match my blue accented website. And I can choose the background, but since it's a white background, I'll just keep it that way. And you can also adjust the padding. Anyway, let's go ahead and update this page and see what it looks like. All right, so scrolling down on my page, you can see that my booking calendar is embedded. So I was mistaken, the background is actually gray here on this page. I couldn't tell on the block editor, but anyway, you can still see that the accent color has turned to blue. So let's go ahead and book a new appointment. All right, and now that I've booked my appointment, here is a confirmation screen, and here's a save to calendar button that I was talking about earlier. The final user, or the user on this confirmation page, can select whether they want to save this to their Google Calendar or to another calendar using ICS, for example, for Apple calendars or Google Outlook, etc. But you can see that in the plugin settings, you can adjust what information is shown to them when they download these. And you can also see that we have a few different actions that the user can take after they book an appointment. For example, if they misspelled their name, they can edit the information. If they find that this time actually doesn't work, they can reschedule, or they can cancel this appointment. And if they select schedule a new appointment, they'll just be taken back to that first initial screen. With that said, let's go take a look at our appointment really quick on the back end, just to show you what that looks like. All right, so here is my new booking. And if we click on it and select view appointment details, you can get all the information that came with that appointment. For example, all the customer information fields. You can see what page they booked on. You can see when this was created. If they are a logged in user, you can see who this was booked by. And you can also tell when the last time it was modified. For example, if they changed their email. And just to give you a quick sneak peek as to what the notification will look like, going to the notifications and selecting one of these for when an appointment is booked. And I'll go ahead and just see what the customer is going to see. As you scroll down, you'll see that you have a few different options for customizing a notification. But for now, I just want to show you the live preview for my newly booked appointment. You can see that the name is pulled in. You can see what website this was booked on. You can also see that the appointment date and time is included, as well as all their details. And they also have the option to cancel or change their appointment using a link included in the emails. So with that said, I hope this was helpful. Please let us know if you have any questions or if you need any help setting this up. We're always happy to help. Feel free to contact our support team, and I'll leave a link for that in the description box below. Thanks again, and I hope you have a wonderful day.